had patients tell me that they, you know, were reviewing places to retire to, and they chose Fairhope because of Thomas Hospital and because of the physicians here in the community. So they knew they had excellent health care.
I love Thomas Hospital because of the friendly atmosphere.
It's, they can view it as a trusted friend or a place where they can have confidence and know that they can come and get a fair assessment.
We do see a lot of the patients that we take care of in the emergency room outside of the hospital, and they always come up to us and say thank you, and they're very grateful for the care we provide here.
The patients feel like they are part of our family too, because they don't feel like they're just a number.
Everybody's really committed to serving the community here. You can see that it's evidenced every day by what the staff does to go above and beyond, the extra mile for taking care of patients, really meeting their needs.
So what you know about sacrifice? When the lights go out, the price you pay when you're digging down. Skin of your teeth and a pain in your back. What you know about hope? What you know about that? Ride it off as criminal, a place to cast a stone. On and on, we carry on when one is not enough. We are the ones who are born to rise.
Stopping us. You can't schedule an illness or injury. That's why AlphaCare Urgent Care is open late every day. The care you need when you need it. Locations in Spanish Fort and Fairhope. AlphaCare Urgent Care. Changing the way healthcare is delivered on the coast.
What's up, Pirate family? This is Riley Leonard, former Fairhope High School quarterback. Just wanted to wish a good luck to both Fairhope and Mary Montgomery tonight. Now, there's nothing like playing under the lights on a Friday night, especially with the fan base and, more importantly, the student section that we have here at Fairhope. So just know I'll be tuning in while up here in Durham. You guys have fun and God bless. Let's go!
Harbin. Yeah, he's a junior with 24 tackles. Open up on that side. Gonna be first down on that 45-yard line.
It is complete. Stopped by Nolan Phillips, the Pirate defense, but it is a first down for Lightning. Sitting on the 45-yard line of Nolan Phillips. Bolton on the pass reception and a nice run down to the 40-yard line of the Pirates. It will be Dallas Booth making the tackle. First down for the Vikings at the 39-yard line.
All right, defense. Let's stop it right here. Okay. First and 10, Vikings. Throws it away. That quarterback is 6 foot
Collins
four.
Throws the ball away. He's second down.
Got the range. That's right. Second and 10.
Watching that they could get a good laugh.
What, you? I'm not going to say a word.
You get all the words.
you make me feel comfortable. All right, second and 10. Let's stack it up in here.
The national anthem got me.
It was beautiful, wasn't it? It always is. Get him in there.
That's holding. Oh.
Touchdown.
Got a flag.
Well, that was holding. You called him way up here in the booth. I like your eyesight. You didn't even need, that's right. You didn't even need your binoculars on that one, buddy.
No,
pretty
sir.
Pretty clear.
After the many years that I've been involved in this, I kind of pick up on some of those things.
Back them on up. It'll be second down again.
Second and 20.
We talked about number 9, Nolan Phillips. We talked about number 40. Also, Brandon Jensen, number 35, 23 tackles. Dixon Davis, number 17, with 22 tackles.
So it looks like Dixon is moved over to corner, and then Mason Henderson moves up to the boundary safety.
Dixon is number 17.
After the penalty, it'll be second and 20 for the Vikings.
Second and 20.
Second and 20. Got a screen.
Oh, get it. Don't let him out of there. That's right.
There you
right.
go. Good
He's
job.
He's going to get 5 or 6 yards. Who's that, number 22?
That's Tyler Bush. One.
Is that Luke? Kamari?
I'm.
So it's kind of hard. You know, yeah,
those
bad
numbers are difficult.
They are very difficult. Their numbers silhouetted on black jerseys.
Luke Kimmerer on the tackle.
Luke, we'll listen to Mike. That'll help us.
You know, he's good. We can. He's got a couple of people over there spotting for him.
Yeah, that
got
makes a little bit of a difference.
Here we go. Third.
So
down.
Third and 15. Good job keeping him in front.
Down. That's good.
Fourth and about 7. Kind of that in-between zone here. Do you punt it? No way that most high school kickers. We had Luke Freer. We could probably kick a field goal. But he's not here. He's playing for Air Force.
Air Force. Air Force Falcons. He sure is.
I think he's getting some punting opportunities these days.
You know,
and
that's
kicking.
Another fine young man. We've got some alumni of this fine institution that we're very proud of all over this country.
Going far
big
at fourth
play,
and 7.
Far
They're just throwing it up.
Oh. That's right. Fourth down. It's ball. Farrell.
He dropped it.
Yeah, we'll take that. You know, whatever it takes, that was holding. That's why that quarterback had plenty of time.
That's correct.
That's good. That was a drop. Thank you.
Yep, it happens. You know, if we were all that good, then we'd be at a different level. So they're learning, and he'll get a little razzing about that over the next couple of days, but he'll move on.
All right. I like stats. Number 12, Jackson Robinson, has thrown the ball 13 times. He's got 10 receptions for 81 yards and a touchdown last week.
Yeah, we're pretty excited about this.
And this is Preston on this is number 3 in the backfield.
Actually, he's at quarterback.
He's quarterback. That's right. Run that ball.
Maybe work in Jackson a little bit slow. There. I apologize. I cannot see those jerseys. Yeah, there's Jackson at the helm now.
The second series here. Second down, that is.
Got
with Preston next to him.
J.J., Sanders, Preston, Tad. Oh,
my goodness. Didn't have a chance to get that developed.
They read that
whatsoever.
One pretty well.
Lost a couple of 3 yards on that. It's gonna
that was a good throw,
down.
Though.
That was a good play. It had.
Yeah, we're not trying to throw it down the field the first opportunity, so that's good. Give him some safe throws to get him a little comfortable.
Feet under him and get ready to go. Jackson in at quarterback. He is a junior. Out in the flat. That's a
they are coming
defense.
Hard. They're not worried about down the field, so we got to.
Swarming defense. Fourth and 11.
We got snapper on this is Clayton Noblet, senior, and then Nolan's going to be the punter in this situation. Nolan had a couple of good ones last week. Clayton is another one of those great young men at the high school.
You're fortunate to walk the halls and get to know these young people.
Good. Ooh. Nice job coverage.
On 40-yard line. You know, I think about this quite a bit. A lot of people ride by that high school. They don't know what's going on inside. We hear the bad things. There's so much good going
on. Oh, my
there.
Gosh. You know, we hear other things across, not necessarily the county, but we hear things from other parts of the state, other states themselves. And knock on wood, I'll tell you, we have a great student body. You know, and there's almost 1,700 of them running around. Are walking around, I should say, but you know, for the most part, they are just spot on. Yes, sir. No, sir. Classroom situation is awesome.
Principal Cardwell will be with us just for halftime.
Yes, sir.
Brag on some of them and let's go.
You know, it was a testament. Let's see, we got first down at the 40, first running play, I believe.
Defense tough in the middle. Who made that stop?
We'll watch the replay there. Looks like the
Dallas Booth.
The two linebackers stepped up, so that would be Dallas, I believe, and Butler. I'm sorry, Patrick Harbin.
Second down. 7 minutes left in the first quarter. Speed to the outside. He got around, got the corner. That's going to be
nice job of pursuit there. We, you know, as coaches, we try to make sure that you never give up on a play because you never know when there's going to be a cutback or a fumble. And if you're in that pursuit angle, you have an opportunity, you know, because he broke that first tackle, and then we had a guy waiting on him there to knock him out of bounds. Got a first down at the 50. Oh, bad snap. Can we get there? Oh,
see,
that's it.
That's those little things that we are very thankful for.
Yeah, and we got to take advantage of those opportunities. So we go from first and 10 to second and third.
We got a ton of wonderful sponsors. We'll mention them along. Alpha Care, they're the new sponsor this year.
Yes, sir.
Right there on Greenville Road, doing a fantastic job. Of course, Thomas Hospital. You're looking at this on high def.
High definition.
High definition.
That means the picture's better, right?
I think so. High def. High def. Third and second in a long way.
Oh. Nice job.
Good coverage.
Looked like
right
a zone
there.
Coverage there, and just followed him to the outside.
And if I could see that number, I'd tell you who he is. But I appreciate him being over there. Was that 11?
I think that's Mason. He's the boundary safety.
That's Mason Henderson.
Yes, sir.
He's 11th grader.
He's a new starter this week based on some personnel issues.
Okay, we got a timeout.
Timeout.
Well, we mentioned Thomas Hospital. Let's talk about somebody else. El Mexicano.
Oh, yeah. I ate there last night. They took good care of me. I tell you what, that Lapita's chicken is pretty doggone special.
Well, I tell you, that's the home of Pirate Nation Live. They're a sponsor. We're very thankful for them.
Maybe there's a group there that can say hello to us. And
I hope they're there.
You know, y'all talked about me last time I was there. Somebody threw out that I was drinking margaritas, and that was not true. I am not. I'm not going to say any names, but I'm not a drinker. I've never had a beer and never plan on it. So
But tantalize your taste buds with their specials and their fresh ingredients prepared daily. Best margaritas around, they tell us.
Well, that's what they say.
I believe.
And I can't tell you that they're not.
Hey, Bayside Orthopedics. I can testify to them. I do that every time. I got two hips, repaired shoulder. Doctor, there's a bunch of doctors.
Oh,
on
yeah.
That.
I talked to them before the game.
Dr. Terrell is my guy.
I coached two of his boys, and then Dr. Carter. I had his girls in basketball. I haven't been around for Dr. Dieterman yet. His are kind of young, so we'll see.
He was a pitcher at LSU, isn't that right?
Yes, sir.
That's right.
He is a pretty athletic young man.
Third and long way. We need coverage.
He's throwing it about a 50-yard.
He's pushing.
Oh, that's –
That's offensive pass interference.
They didn't call it on. They've got something back here.
Well, that makes me a bit nervous if it was that. Look like he was pushing off. That's exactly where he was pushing off. Let's see what they have to say about that. Oh, they called it on us. Well. Will that be a first down? Automatic?
Automatic first down, yep.
Replay third. They've changed some things up on that. I'm confused. I hadn't read all the rule book. I depend on the white hat out there.
Yes, sir.
But there's several things that have changed. In the old days, that would have been a penalty and I think a first automatic first down. But it's third and 11, just over 10. He threw that ball from about the 35.
Yeah, that was about 45 yards or more in the air. We're getting good pressure. We're pushing them backwards.
Good pressure. Don't let him out on this corner. Good.
Boom, that a boy.
I got to see that number. Come on.
Run him down.
That's
number two.
Dallas.
Dallas Booth.
Dallas Booth. My goodness, that's beautiful. Fourth down. They're going to punt it to us this time, I think.
It'll be fourth down for the Vikings.
There's 5 minutes left in the first quarter, and so far there's been some miscues. But we're grateful to be right where we are. We're going to have to get this offense moving, march down the field, and let's get some points.
All right. I think that's Tad all the way back.
Tad Mitchell.
Not a great snap. Ooh, well, good job putting pressure on him. Out of bounds.
That's a 50-yard line.
It should be up here somewhere.
Yeah, let's see. Come on.
He got it at the 40.
goes out of bounds around midfield. All right, we got an opportunity here. You know, what caused that? Pressure?
Pressure. If you notice, we're putting pressure on that offensive line to make him have to go backwards, him being the quarterback, moving backwards, and he's just feeling that pressure. It's not necessarily there on him, but he just feels that pressure coming towards him, and then he's trying to get outside to make something happen with his legs. I don't agree with that spot because that ball went out of bounds at an angle farther up the field, but obviously they can't see that. But we have a little different
vantage point from up here. That's right, we got a good angle here. On our 49-yard line.
Quick throw to Sanders.
They're so quick out on the corners there. Yeah.
What I know as a former offensive guy calling plays, they are setting them up. They are fixing to throw the ball
down the field.
So they're going to
– Well, let's just keep that amongst ourselves. Yeah,
hopefully those people in –
Those Viking
Sims
coaches
that might
are
be
right
watching.
Above our heads. We can hear them. They can't hear us.
Yeah. So he's throwing the ball well. Oh, that might have been a good play there.
That number 21 made me a bit nervous over here.
For us?
No, for him. Let's see.
Devin Petway, outside linebacker, middle linebacker.
Yeah, he kind of had this area over here, but it looked like a good play starting.
So two former Pirates are watching from Delta State, I believe, up in Cleveland, Mississippi. Both those guys played for the Pirates last year, so good to hear from Ryan and Maddox. Hopefully, a little bit high. That's
a little bit high.
It's a long throw. And then got some people from Clinton, Missouri. Truman Lake, so they're watching there. But Jackson's looking comfortable. I'm excited for him to, the more this game goes, the more he's going to be comfortable at throwing the ball and kind of running the offense. Right now I think the play calling is running the offense, and he's going to get to a point to where he's feeling the game. So,
hey, look, also Preston is a heck of an athlete and a running back. He's open.
Oh,
he
heck of a comeback.
Ball.
Great.
He caught that ball.
Great
on the
back shoulder throw.
Step. That's what we're talking about.
And Tad came down. I believe that's Tad, number 14.
Tad Mitchell.
Yeah, baseball player. You know, love those dual athletes. So, real excited for Tad.
You know, it gives us a little momentum, a little confidence. 3 minutes and 47 seconds in the first. Hey, here's a shout out to number 72, Chad Stewart. On the Pirates' O-line, cheering him on from home.
Yep.
Hey, we're hoping you're here with us, but if you're not, we're glad you tuned in. Ooh, he hit a wall.
Yeah, we got a little manhandled there by that defensive line. They may have had a twist or a stun on there.
I don't have sizes, but I can just tell from here. That's a beef.
Quickness probably has a lot to do with that. Oh, a little trickery. Atta boy.
Oh, my goodness.
I got to pay attention. Good old Preston.
You
got to love Preston.
Not, but that was a nice hug.
Yeah, good gesture on his part.
You got to be ready on that sidelines, man. There's a football game going on. Was there a penalty on the play?
Surely. Yep, holding. You know, while we got a little break, we'll talk about the freshman football team. They are 2-0 with a game that got suspended with Spanish Fork. We're going to call it a win. It was halftime, or right before halftime. We were winning 19-0. So they're playing really well. They beat Foley last week 41-15. And that group is going to be special as they continue to grow and understand this offense and just physically get bigger.
Hey, the future's bright. I think we've got over 30. We've got over 30 seniors on this team. So,
They are keying on them, too.
We
threw the ball down the field one time and made a good play out of it. So I think Coach Joel is going to He's setting them up. He's got method to the madness, as they say.
You mentioned it when Tad made that catch. He came back for that ball.
Right.
He caught it at the upper point.
So we got third
Everybody
and
knows
a bunch.
This is a passing down, third and 20.
Nice catch.
Nice plays.
Fumble.
That is. That was a fumble. Okay, defense, let's step back up.
So the freshmen, some of the offensive guys that are doing really well right now are Trey Gardner. He's the quarterback. You got Cooper Bell, who's a receiver. And then Nick Rotsvalley is one of the running backs for those guys. And defensively, you got Braden Bradley, Jamison Stevens, and Owen Reinick, who is offensive and defensive linemen. So we're real excited about that group
coming forward.
And
they're 2-0, and you're claiming that one that was suspended.
Oh, yes, sir.
I would as well. First down, they're on their own 44-yard line. Tough running, good defense. Going to gain 2 or 3 yards.
So Leo forgot to talk about my snapper for the middle for the freshman team is Luke Classide, and I apologize if I say that wrong. And then Leo Palumbo. I deal with Leo, and he's a super young man in my study hall in fourth period. So they're
a
lot of fun.
The
they tell me a lot of
the ninth grade team.
Yes, sir. Well, Leo's the kicker actually.
Oh,
and
I see.
The snapper is Luke.
Hey. That's good pursuit out on that other side. Bringing up third down.
Now we're getting good pressure.
We are.
In the middle. You know, he hadn't really just sat in there and thrown the ball except for that called touchdown back.
A lot of those snaps are high. Of course, one over his head. Be a good time for that. No, that was a perfect snap.
A little screen.
And screen. Boom!
Ooh. That's the way
that's
you do
defense
it
right
there.
Right there. Tell me who that was.
Adams makes a big stick for the Pirates.
Looks like the outside linebacker.
Another loss will be fourth down and 10 for the Vikings.
Fourth and 10. That was a great play right there. We're running down 40 seconds left in the first period of play.
Let's see. We didn't have a very good punt the last time.
Hey,
the snap.
That screen was set up well. But Adam met him right at the right.
Oh,
there it is. This could be good. It's good.
Special
there you go.
Teams
we'll
are
take
huge
it.
Part, huge part of the game, and their long snapping is
having some trouble. We got 12 seconds left in the first period. Stephanie Rees, hey there. We're watching from the Pirate Closet, listening to us broadcast. Y'all are doing an amazing job. You are too kind to us. Thank you so much. Y'all do an amazing job down at that.
That Pirate Closet's got the
that
stuff.
That retail place, isn't it?
If you need something that has a pirate on it.
Oh, right,
she's
so talking
we got about first
us
down.
Broadcast. Us. That's us. That's us.
All right.
Run the ball, Preston.
Good job by the offensive line. I'm telling you, Coach, is setting up some plays for later, second half. It looks like they got
that's,
a slow
that's
player
be the end
getting up.
Of the first period. They had a big guy number four having a little issue there. Commercial. We're going to, is this a Thomas Hospital?
All right, everyone. We have another special announcement we'd like to for you to hear. This is really important. The National Merit Scholarship Program announced that 16,000 National Merit Scholarship city finalists this week.
You get the chance to make a difference to that, not only to that patient in terms of providing them the care that they need, but also the family, helping them understand what's going on and have some reassurance that the patient's getting good care.
We all have something good to bring to the table to take the best care of our patients that we can.
It just feels like family. It feels like we're taking care of family while we're here.
Fairhope in general has grown a lot, and I feel like Thomas Hospital is the cornerstone for our community.
We're able, you know, to form those relationships with families and spend time with them, which is really special that I feel here.
Not only does our community give to us, we give back to our community. We want to be able to provide the care that they are looking for right here in Baldwin County.
You can't schedule an illness or injury. That's why AlphaCare Urgent Care is open late every day. The care you need when you need it. Locations in Spanish Fort and Fairhope. AlphaCare Urgent Care, changing the way healthcare is delivered on the coast.
Scott, we got second and 7 from just about the 16-yard line.
So we can get a first down, which is awesome. We want time off the clock because tonight with their high-scoring offense, we want to take time off the clock where we can score. And then defensively, I think we're doing a good scheme. We're in the right places. You know, we've got to make sure that the quarterback stays intact as far as
Look at fight for yardage. You're right. Preston, we love you, man. He's on the 10-yard line. Number 62, Stephen Strong from Clinton, Missouri.
Yep.
Clinton, Missouri. Appreciate you tuning in to see Stephen Strong.
All right, so we got third down and about one. So
big play here. Say that all the time. They're all big plays.
That looks like we get, well, I think that's Robertson at quarterback.
He cut it inside.
I
think he got a first down. I tell you what, I think he's close enough that we're going to go for it because you're right. We need to run the clock. Keep the ball away from them.
Short. Man.
Fourth and a foot.
I'd at least try to get them off sides and burn a timeout here.
You know, that could have been so much worse because that defensive end met him in the backfield, but he cut inside. Need about a
big play right here, obviously. We want
to move over. That shift confuses me all the time.
He jumped offside.
That's going to give us a first down. That's good coaching right there. Is that not right?
That is correct. But they're saying on their side that we coerced them into moving.
I don't agree with that.
It's like the old Dallas Cowboys back in the day when they would go up and back down. That's a legal play. Nobody set. So he's discussing it, and the coach is on
both sides of the field are out there. What say ye?
Man in the white hat.
He's looking in the right direction. Encroachment. I just made that up.
It's a term.
Yep. That's right.
There you go. You've heard that word before.
Man, I'll tell you the truth. We'll take it. That's half the distance to the goal. Their coach is having a fit. That's okay.
His heart rate went up a little bit.
It did.
Blood pressure.
But I'm telling you, things so far to me just feel better. Feel right.
Yeah.
Things are happening that need to happen. We need to talk about somebody, don't we, Des?
I can talk about all the athletic teams at the hospital.
Hey, do that.
So
don't forget the fishing team. Hunter Security.
They do an awesome job for us, been supporting. And I actually coached Scott Hunter when he was in high school. So I've known him for quite a while.
Wait a minute. How long have you been teaching?
I've been in Baldwin County since 1988.
That's 35 years.
It's been a while.
You got a little gray in the beard. I noticed that.
When I got here, I was 22. If you saw the thing with Coach Dean
last
week, I was the person on the right – farthest one on the right side. So I was actually able to coach with Coach Dean in the late 80s when we had some All-Americans playing here.
I'm telling you, you're right. Anyway, Mark, we Lewis. Appreciate Scott, and we appreciate Hunter Security. They have over half. They're Thomas Roofing, man. If you want a roof, they're the people to call. We got a first and goal from the 6-yard line.
All right, you've got 10 minutes to buy your slip of pot ticket with a pot.
This is big.
Tonight, keeping a lot of money in the pot going to the winner.
I had to come out of that. My Fairhope fishing team hat. So
that's okay.
We have some of those if anybody needs them. Catch up with me or Coach Cole.
Well, you and I both are follically impaired, but that's all. That Dez is too. We better not stand just right. We'll be like a pawn shop sign. First and goal from the 6-yard line. Pirates.
There he goes.
He's close. Raise some hands. Touchdown! I got to apologize when I yell like that. I was told it was too loud and it might hurt some ears. I can't help it.
No doubt. We got to be excited.
We got to be excited about that. That was
good
defense.
We're doing exactly what we needed to do to control the game. We're playing really good defense. We're not making mistakes on offense. We're controlling the time on the clock, which is the big thing for tonight. We want to be able to control that time.
Well, we got a lot of football to play with 10 minutes left before halftime, but so far it's lining up right. It's good. It's
Knoblet
7.
With a good snap. Knoblet will have a chance to snap and play at the next level, so we're excited about his opportunities.
You know, we noticed their snapper having a bit of a problem. Maybe that'll continue.
Yes, sir. That
we'll take
definitely
whatever,
put us where we were on that, so we got to take advantage of those situations.
Hey, one more thing in this little before we kick off. There are 3 more Region 1 games tonight. Alma Bryan is hosting Citronelle. Daphne is over at Davison, and Baker is at Foley. Now, this is a game we're focusing on. This is a game we're working on. But if we get a score on some of those,
we'll let you know. Citronelle is not in the league, so Alma Bryan is out. But the other two are region games.
That's right.
So, quick shout out to the girls' basketball program. They have a spirit night next Monday, and I know that's a conflict for football people, but they're trying to raise some money for an opportunity to go to.
Where will that be?
That'll be at Taco Mama's in Daphne.
Got it. That's good kickoff if we'll.
Uh-oh. Good job of pursuit. That's a good run back by them. But if we don't have that pursuit at that angle, then we don't make that tackle, and they're going to the
house. He was right at the edge of the sidelines over here. Of course, all these good-looking Fairhope Pirates were blocking our view, but he must have not stepped out. He's going to have first and 10 on the 35-yard line.
Yep. That's one thing that over the last 2 years we've had, or actually 4 years with Luke and Brian, to be able to kick the ball deep.
Deep.
And that, unfortunately, is not the kicker's forte.
All right, well, step up defense. Do like you know to do.
As the old adage goes, bend but don't break. So we got
it. Don't break. Rock Gilhart, number 29, is on this side, right? Yes, him.
Nice job of tackle open field. They put that in a one-on-one situation, just ran it out. That guy's got a strong enough arm to make that on the line. And it's hard to defend because if he comes up real hard, then he just goes by him and he throws it over the top.
Our number 86 is Brockton Norris. I can't see that he's out there. I think that he is. I'm pretty sure
he's your left defense. He's on the right side tonight.
Deshaun Williams, number 94, and Dieter Kraus, in number 43. That little trickery right there. We staying at home.
Be nice to have a fumble. So
tonight,
starting, according to what I have, is Brockton is an end, Rock is a defensive tackle. Deshaun is a defensive tackle. Patrick Harbin is an end. Dallas is a Sam linebacker. Patrick is
Mike linebacker.
Mike, and then Brandon Jensen is the Will linebacker. Your defensive backs are Amir, Mason, Nolan, and Dixon Davis moved over from safety. They're doing a heck of a job right now.
So far, they really are. Let's keep it going. Quarterback draw. He's met at the line of scrimmage. Little rugby
Staking
scrum.
The ball.
Crum.
Pursuit.
Down.
You know, they do a great job coaching these guys to
Fly
not
to
give
the
up
ball.
The. Yes, all 11 hats to the ball. And that's one of the things that they don't take a playoff. They're always going where they're supposed to. And that makes a difference when you have that cutback and that ball is there and we're right there to make that tackle.
We're in two down territory. It's third and two.
Oh, nice tackle.
Yes, that's right. Play failed the game.
That's number 86, Brockton Norris on the tackle. They're going to, looks like a heavy set for the Vikings.
Number seven, their quarterback is, yeah, they getting
he's
big package coming in. Going to some kind of wildcat, is that what that would be?
I don't know why you take number seven out for that purpose. He's got to be your best athlete.
We're stacked in the middle. Let's.
Holding.
That's it. Yeah. Look around the side. This side. Wow. We were stacked in the middle, ready for that. Came around this way. That was quickness. They put him in there for his feet.
Yeah, you would be right. Not to say that the other guy couldn't get it done, but he may be the backup, and they're trying to give him some love.
That's right. Bad snap.
So Mr. Jake Marcus, who's a huge fan of the Pirates, got a son that plays basketball, just texted me from down in Florida. So we appreciate them listening and watching. Super supportive and just a great person overall, that whole family. So
absolutely. We got Don and Brian Mosley. Boy, what big supporters of education in Bowen County. Remember Ben?
I do know Ben. His parents are
tuning in tonight. We appreciate
super
that
supportive
very much.
And Bulldog fans, I believe. Which yes. I don't know much about them Bulldogs.
You know a lot about those Bulldogs.
All right, hey, so they drive down the field
yeah.
after a pretty good kickoff, and the outcome of that is a touchdown, and can't give up the momentum here. We got to go down and score. Or at least get good field position and keep them out of the
end zone. Yeah, how do you answer? That's correct. I don't know if we've got crowd shots here. We got a full stadium on this side. It's neon night. We got students dressed up in fluorescent, you name it.
We had four colors, green. Well, it was lime green
yeah.
or yellow for the freshmen, green. For the sophomores, orange for the juniors, and then pink for the seniors. And they did a really good job of showing their support today.
Yeah, we got a great group of students, and well-behaved in the stadium. That's the pooch kick. Fair ooh. Catch called.
Good job. I believe that's not who I thought it was. 21.
Was that 21?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
That's nope, that's incorrect. Because Blake, that's Walker Rux. There's two 21s on my roster. And
there you go.
I know Blake is.
He's defensive back, and that's yep. wide receiver. Walker Rux, Dr. Rux's son. Okay, offense, we said this before. How do you respond?
Time off the clock with first downs and just move methodically down the field.
I know we don't have a clock, and sometimes when I'm watching, I'm wondering how much time we try to keep you posted. He
Oh,
well, that was almost 50.
That's a tough angle.
That was a tough angle. That was Sanders Daniel.
Quarterback, that maybe throw that one a little bit quicker and give him an opportunity to catch it at a better angle, because he's trying to throw that thing over his inside shoulder.
And that stops the clock 7 minutes.
Our boy Barrett Kane, I don't know if you saw the end of that play on the far side. There's a good little screen. The fumble picked it up. Good job.
We can advance that.
That's correct.
Fumble was picked up by the Pirates.
Got to hold on to that thing on this end.
Hold on to it, Preston. Absolutely right. Let's move third down, and where are we? About two or three. Put the ball down on 41-yard line.
It'll be 33 for the Pirates. Ball sitting at the 41-yard line.
Big play. Another big play. Preston took the snap. He's going to have a first down. Brings the ball all the way to the 45-yard line. Spot it right.
You know, that's a pretty good opportunity for us to have
a duel
with
yep.
And your center does a really good job because you don't know who they're going to snap it to.
That's right.
Oh, that's a little high.
A little high. Settle down. A little high.
Everything's short right now, and I'm thinking here in just a minute they're going to
pop it down the field. Hello from Wetumpka, Alabama, from Park Glaze's baby sister Lily. Hello, Lily. Thank you for tuning in to Pirate Nation Live. Good luck to Park Glaze. He got a yard or two.
So I did a little research with some of the players today, and over the week, and I did a little questionnaire, and so here are the three questions that I asked. What is your favorite memory as a Pirate? What is a game day superstition that you and the team or the team has? And then what is your favorite football tradition, NFL all the way down to City League? Nice throw. Get outside. Not great play design. He's got to make that block to be able to get to the outside.
So you took that survey with football players.
Yes, sir. And the one that I've gotten that I liked is, what is your game day superstition? And Luke, who's a senior, number 22, plays linebacker. He said, never eat Golden Corral for pregame. So
it might not be Golden Corral. It's how much in that all.
Well, that's true.
Yeah.
And then his favorite football tradition is his pregame nap. So,
pregame nap.
Yeah. So that it's been fun to read over these. And he said his favorite memory was winning the region last year, or the year before, sorry.
Hey, look at Scott. I read hello from Wetumpka from Park Glaze's baby sister, Lily. Look at that precious baby.
Is that the baby sister?
My voice just changed. That's a precious baby, dude. Huh? Oh, can I put it on there? Can you see that? Oh, it's terrible. I don't know how to. Oh, there it is. That's almost it. That's
there
a
you go.
Baby. We didn't violate any laws, did we?
Well, we don't want to talk about them. All right, so we got fourth down and about four. We're going to punt.
Yeah.
Nolan's back, and then Clayton's going to snap it for us.
Move them chains, baby. Let's go, Pirate. Watching from Los Angeles.
It would have been nice
Kevin
if they had
Gray
jumped
Jr.
off sides.
Love the legend, Coach Dean. I imagine Kevin Gray and you about Coach Dean.
Yes, sir.
Oh, no.
Run with it. Run it.
Run!
That didn't
Turned
end up
to
too
be
bad.
A good punt. Let it roll down the sidelines.
Good job.
That was one of those things we're really grateful to. It turned out that way it did.
Patrick Harbin, who's a class, he's a junior, defensive end, number 40. What is your favorite memory? Was going to Auburn for the playoff game last year.
Yeah.
And so his pregame, or game day superstition, excuse me, is he drinks pickle juice before every game. If you don't know about that, that has to do with hydration and keeping the cramps away. So that's
and it tastes good, too.
I'm a dill pickle fan, so yeah.
Hey, great job, guys. Joey Desmond. Thank you, Joey.
Good old Joey. And his favorite football tradition is the team breakfast on game day. So that's pretty cool because they get in there and the local people furnish that.
That's right. That's not a Golden Crow. Get him back.
See, we're getting pressure.
That was just that's an outstanding nice, catch.
Nice throw and catch.
We had good coverage. We pressured the quarterback. He made a good.
We got something going on. Oh, there's a flag down here.
Back it up. Holding. No wonder he had some time. We talk about that reverberation and all that out. Back it on up. That's good. Hey, let's don't forget any of our sponsors. We are so grateful for that's so much better. Thank you, Des.
Oh, yeah. Ooh.
Yeah, that is. Thank you very much. It's first and 15. The ball is on the 10-yard line. We got good pressure that last time. Let's do that again.
Yep, just got to keep that outside containment.
They got two over here. You're going to hand it off that right side.
Gain of about six, right at five. So, hadn't heard much, and being a home game, probably not a ton of people at LMX, but we're hoping those who are there are enjoying that really good food.
Hey, here's a nice lady from Sims, watching from Sims. We love our Vikings, Troy and Brenda Finley. Thank you all for tuning in. We're sorry to be biased, but we are. That was a beautiful play. Just
hold
the wrong
on.
Color. Oh,
fumble.
Good.
Nope.
Yeah, well, we thank you for tuning in. And
just missed him.
I hope you can hear us and see. Have mercy on us. Watching from Greenville, Alabama, sending a shout-out to our grandson, Will Cooper, number 88. He's a 10th grader. You know Will?
I do. Super young man. Got a pressure. Bad angle.
He got a... Not going to be a first down.
Nope. We'll be third in about two.
Go Pirates. We have a son on the ninth grade team and also one in the youth tackle for 12-year-old, and they are both excited to be there tonight. We sure do like watching Pirate Nation live from home, from the comforts of your home. Maybe you got a wide screen. The bathroom's right down the hall, the refrigerator, that's just the way to go if you can't be out here with us. It's fun being here. Will Reed.
Will Reed.
War Eagle.
I can't say it, Will. I'm sorry.
Hey, Will, I say it twice.
I love you, but I just
man,
can't do it.
I am loving keeping up with you, man. He was a hydration coordinator for the Pirates about 10 years ago.
He was my camera guy.
Get him right there.
That little joker's quick.
He's quick. Oh, man. But we appreciate you tuning in. He shot us a screenshot. Look at there.
Appreciate you, Will. Good luck tomorrow.
Absolutely.
So real quick, the Fairhope basketball is hosting two more youth skill development sessions for young Pirates grades 3 through 6. It's open to boys and girls from 5 to 6:30 the 17th and the 24th. So you get a chance.
Be there. 3 minutes left till halftime. 7-7 is first and 10. They're on about the 36-yard line. Number 7, who we talked about quite a bit.
Long throw.
Way down the field.
Oh, he's wide open.
Oh, he overthrew it. Hey, I'm really relieved here. No, sir, no laws, especially with parental consent. Thank you. That's a precious baby.
Yep. Well, thank you for that. Go Vikings.
I didn't know if that was a dirty word. The word is S-K-O-L, Skol Vikings.
Let's go.
Hey, look at that. That's legal procedure. Oh, both. Skol, that's Viking talk.
Yep, it probably is.
Adam and Margaret Gambino. Makes me hungry.
Yep, anytime you say that,
yeah,
you know, y'all, up north it might be a little different thought process, but here it's
right.
About
hey,
food.
We love you guys. Thank you for all that you do. I hope the plants at the middle school are okay.
So Kathy Hudson, who is our swim team coach, they are hosting this coming week a swim meet at the Fairhope Pool. Starts at 5:30. So if you get a chance, run out there and watch some of our five seniors. We have some two-time state champions in that situation.
I got a question for you. How many teams do we have? I mean, just think about that. I'm going to pitch it out there.
Nice job, Pursuit.
We didn't give up on it. He's going to be inside the 5-yard line, 55 seconds.
Yep.
He cut that right side. You're right. We didn't give up on the play, but what a speedy speedster that is. This is Todd Hoffman. Hello from Sims, rooting for the Mary G. Montgomery Vikings. Skol Vikings. Thank you, Todd. Appreciate you taking the time to do that. Pass snap. That's right. That's what we were looking for. That's yep. About the third time, I do believe.
So two-time state champ Lena Amari. Super athlete.
Yes, she's a fine young lady.
Yep, and then two-time state meet medalist Noah Greer, state meet relay medalist Anastasia Newton, state meet qualifier Carl Sherritt, and state meet qualifier James Case. So those are our seniors this year.
Second down, long way to go. The ball's on about the 13-yard line.
Just throwing it up.
Up.
A little too far. He's struggling throwing the deep ball tonight. Obviously, he made that good throw early, but he's just not quiet because he had us in that corner.
Here's an announcement. Hey, Cecil, go Pirates. Orrin Gillespie wants you to know, and everyone on PO Pirate Nation Live, the girls' volleyball just beat St. Michael's in three sets and are on their way to the game.
So they played today. They have a tournament this weekend. A couple of the girls are in my classes. They're ranked in the top 10 right now.
I'm telling you, they got some talent on that team.
I watched them last night pretty much destroy Gulf Shores.
Oh,
they didn't feel good about their 5A ranking.
Oh, my gosh, he sent that.
Nice job.
Nice job. Run
I'm sorry, I can't tell who that is.
I wish I could see. I can't quite see, but it's a minute, 50 seconds. The clock is running. Fourth down.
Number 7 is not happy. He's limping a little bit. We don't want him to be injured.
We don't want him to be injured. I hope he's fine in the morning.
Yeah, there you go.
Okay, 10 o'clock tonight. No, that's not the way to be. Shout out to the Fairhope Middle School football team. Good luck versus Central Baldwin this coming week. Go Pirates, Rez. Trying to field goal. Long snapper. How long is 19? It's 29 yard long. It is good. 29 yard field goal. And in 10 seconds left, they're up by three. Let me say this.
Here are sophomore cheerleaders for 2023 varsity.
I'm pleased.
Oh, yeah.
I'm pleased.
Give up
I'm pleased
a big play.
Yes.
And then hold them to a field goal.
That
defense is playing hard. The only thing I worry about is them getting a little tired later on in the game. Now, we're in super good shape. The coaches do a great job of conditioning these guys.
Yes.
But – you know, you get out here in 82 degree.
I noticed that at the first game of the year at Spanish Ford, fourth quarter.
Oh, yeah. We were much better shaped than they were.
I saw hands on hips on those. That was, I knew these guys out here had been through the condition. Hey, Dennis Watson has tuned in, and I did not know that Hunter Frazier is his grandson. Do you know Dennis? Wonderful guy. He's stuck at home, but right now, I'm able to watch on my phone, and he's grateful for that. He's enjoying hearing this, and you probably don't know, and I didn't, that you're Hunter's grandfather. Thanks, Dennis. Appreciate it. Shout out to number 72 on the Pirates, cheering him on from home. Can't make it to this game, but I'll be back at the next one. Let's go, Pirates. Let's go, Pirates. Here comes John Cardwell. We're so always glad to see him. Pooch kick goes out of bounds. Yes, it goes out of bounds. We got a minute.
Mr. Cardwell, you looking good tonight with the blue on.
Look,
you like the rest of us.
You need to put these on because he needs to talk to you. You need to brag about some ACT. We've already talked about the students in our high school. Now, I know they're your babies.
They are.
Oh, you like them when they're in the building. Talk about it, man. We got some good things to talk about. Scott, talk to this man.
Yes, sir.
Don't be nervous.
Don't be nervous.
No. I got it. Oh, we got a minute nine. Taking over from Cecil, I feel like I took the A team out of here, man. Right, good gracious.
So I thought we did well to be able to get a field goal out of that situation instead of giving up a touchdown. So
I tell you,
pretty excited about that.
They're scrappy, man. They line up every week. You look at the other side, and I wouldn't trade them for anything.
No.
These kids are great.
And they work hard, pleasant to be around. So that's exciting because I've been at other places that – we're not quite as exciting.
They're like my kids. I tell them I love you all the time and only like you half the time. So that's how we roll. I'm telling you, on that football team, I don't know if y'all saw it in the 30-plus, there were like six or seven of them standing down there. Had cheerleaders running down. I'm telling you, 63 kids with 30 or better on the ACT. All right, scoot down. Desmond's bossing me around. I'm trying to brag on kids over here.
We're trying
around
to get where you can be seen.
I mean, I know I'm no Jack Burrell, Desmond, but I mean, you know, come on.
This is the
camera.
So that's 16.
Oh, we're on camera? Oh, that's – let me suck it in a little bit, Des. Oh, can I hold it up higher?
Yeah.
You don't see
we just
my
want
chin?
The mug.
Oh, good gracious.
So it looks and like a timeout. So tell us a little bit about what's going on at school.
Man, school is awesome right now. We've got – I'll tell you, I'll start with our pre-K class. Those little kids, it's one of the best groups we've had. Little four-year-olds running around, bossing the big ones around. You see them all the time. It's hilarious. And then this ninth grade group is jamming. I'll tell you, I really want to brag on this senior group. We took a dip in our test scores, but this group has come in, and we're at the highest we've been since 2018. We made it through all that COVID mess, but our kids are back now. And, you know, you got that many. Four perfect scores on the ACT.
Unbelievable.
I think the three of us right here might have a 36 if we put it all together. And
maybe.
I'd be bringing y'all down, I promise.
Well, we don't talk about that at my house.
Oh, Lord. Yeah,
Aiden's one of those.
Your
my
kid's
son is,
one of them. Scott Aiden Berry is up there. Yep. If you come to the school, you walk down that hall, you see the banners and stuff. It's just something. It reminds me. It makes it good to go to work every day.
Yes, sir. I just noticed one of the hardest working young men is Barrett Kane, plays left tackle for us. You talk about turning a motor on when he steps inside those lines, whatever sport it is, he is fun to watch.
Barrett, I'm not supposed to have favorites, but 52 is my guy. I go out there and watch. I call him the big uglies in practice, and he is the one of the ugliest of the bigs.
Yep.
But he scraps, wants to plays basketball, wants
baseball.
To play baseball just to be
He'd
in the dugout.
He'd probably throw the shot put if he could.
He could, I tell you. But he's nasty. I love him. He's great.
So National
Merit semifinalists. We recognized a couple of them. One of them's in band. He's so smart, he forgot to come down there. But I tell you, National Merit semifinalists is a huge deal, because if you become a finalist, you get free rides to Alabama. We've had some that have gone to Florida in the past, and it's free rides for doing that. And we got four semifinalists. And Lino Mari is one of them. You're talking about a dynamic swim state champion last year, like two years ago.
Yeah, we just actually talked about the swim team, and she was the first name that I brought up.
Awesome. Yeah, if you haven't been to a swim meet, you need to go, because Kathy Hudson could invade a small country with that group. They are the most organized,
Sir.
As they get there, they show up. It's awesome. That's a good group.
They really embody hard work.
Yes.
Because
yes.
They just, they're steady at that opportunity.
Cecil, Chris, and Barry just told me I talk too much. I don't know if y'all realize that, but Cecil tells you talk too much. Maybe it's time for me to.
I've never said that.
Maybe it's time for me to shut up a little bit.
So athletics at Fairhope is moving forward. We've got a new track coming that's going to be close to campus. We're looking at a new facility on campus that we're going to break ground possibly soon.
And that's fantastic. We're going to have a new indoor facility, weight training for our female athletes. We're going to have a second gym, which not only helps us. I mean, Scott, you coach JV girls, finding time, but also City League. I told Mayor Sullivan, we talked when this came up. I said, man, I will give you the keys, and it gives them somewhere else, because the better they are in fifth grade, the better they're going to be when they get to be junior.
It also helps with parking, if I'm correct in that. Yeah. It'll alleviate some of that back 40 parking that we kind of struggle 40, with.
Yeah,
with,
it's the first thing they're going to do is build a parking lot for us, and they're going to spread that out, and then it'll take some of the parking we have, but we're going 400, 500 new spots. So
that's
with
awesome.
Our growth, Scott, it's unreal.
It's amazing how well our school functions with the amount of people that's in that building.
Think about it. Where you and I, it's a small town. Every day, it's a small town, and those kids get in that parking lot, and they're out of there in 15 minutes. Our car line's empty, the buses are gone, and the parking lot's empty in 15 minutes. It's crazy.
And I drive a bus, and in 6 minutes, from 3:15 to 3:21, we're rolling out of there. And I watch the parking lot, and it's just, the police officers do a great job, David and Ron, moving people out of there, and of course Mr. Wilson and the freshmen in the area, and then you guys, Mr. Helms there with our situation. So
brag too, Fresh. Our SROs and Fairhope Police and everything they do for us, man. I mean, you look around, there's 15, 20 cops here tonight, and some of them are here off the clock. They're just Shane Nolte organizes it. I mean, we got the best, man.
And
it's
what I see outside looking in from that situation is they know the students and they have a rapport. It's not the students are trying to get away from them. They want to come talk to them. And you were talking about the pre-K earlier, Ron and David are right there with them, and that's a great opportunity to show that uniform is a positive.
Yes, and Dave and Ron, they're about relationships. This is not a got you thing. This is them wanting what's best for our kids. They're standing down there talking about this kid and that kid, and I think they know more than I do. But they're great. They really are.
So the band, one of the bigger groups that we've had, just doing a great job. and ambassadors for us.
Yes.
Throughout the county, the state, we're well known. I think we are going on a trip this year.
I think they're marching in a parade. Laura Meredith wears me out. She does such a great job. And our kids, they look great. They got their new uniforms on. It's 100 degrees, and they were like, we're wearing our new units tonight.
That's awesome.
But our band has such a great tradition. Parents all over the place looking down there. It's one of my favorite things. Our student section, just the whole experience here. Riley talking earlier, talking about Friday Night Lights. This is what it's about right here. Well, Ryan McNeil just told me I look good. So, Ryan, you're my favorite graduate.
Fly somewhere, we'll be good.
Yes, exactly.
So he actually texted me earlier and told me that we weren't on sound-wise, so we figured that out. But youth football tonight, the class of 73, just a huge opportunity for Fairhope to come together under the lights, and that's happening all across America. And, you know, we have our little niche here, and it's just awesome.
Hey, Scott, we've been other places, and we come here. Man, there's something special about Fairhope. When you walk down on that field, and it looks like just fake grass, and then they come out in the cannon with Charlie, it's just an experience, man. I wouldn't trade this for anything.
No, and I've had opportunities to go other places, and I said, this is where I want to be. I want to retire here. Of course, I don't know if you realized last week when they played the thing for Joe Dean.
Yes.
I was the youngest guy on that staff.
Oh, really?
And I was in the picture on the far right side with a lot of hair. And so
looked a little different,
but I was fortunate enough to coach with Joe, and that was an awesome opportunity to learn and understand how relationships are built with the player and the student. So,
tradition here, Scott, you've been here longer. They asked me the other day, school spirit. I said, Scott Berry. But Joe Dean, just everybody that's been WC Majors, Joe Dean, and Mike and Alice Dean down on the field the other night, man, that was awesome. Yeah. I mean, that's tradition.
And that's what Fairhope has. And you talk to anybody that graduated from here, they talk about blue and gold.
Yes, yes.
And, you know, some of them kind of get a little frustrated because we don't have enough gold in our uniform. So helping Coach Gilson and the girls' basketball program, I'm like, we got to get some more gold somewhere in our attire.
Coach, and I tell them all the time, if you could give them 100, they'd be mad you didn't get 5 times. So that's just the way it goes. They're going to love you one day and not the next. So. But, yeah, our coaching staff, you mentioned Gabby Gilson, man. Relationships and tough and just getting after it. And, you know, boys, watch those kids, Spencer and that little group, man. It's going to be fun to watch this year.
Well, as a teacher and a coach, my goal is for a student, athlete or not, to not go the other way when they see me.
Yes.
And I think all of our coaches and teachers are that way. They're going to come to them as opposed to go away because of those relationships.
Yeah, I tell you, you can teach all day long, but if you don't have a relationship, I mean, you're wasting time. And it rules. You can have 1,000 rules, but if that kid doesn't respect you, you're dead in the water. So,
and, you know,
that's what we preach. And y'all do. You know, Scott, you do a great job. Kids come up to you all the time. I taught them 2 years ago. That's what we want.
Well, and our administrators, you know, there are some places that, you know, oh my gosh, here comes so and so. I don't see that at Fairhope High School. I see, you know, Mr. Wilson, Mr. Howell, Mr. Helms, Ms. Leidecker.
Yeah.
They're coming to them and saying, hey, I did this, or I made this on my test today, or, you know, my job's going great. Yep. So those things are what makes teaching exciting.
And you can't measure. You can't give them a test to know that, hey, that teacher cares about me. I looked down there and saw the Richleys. I got a mom and a daughter. They're here. They don't have a kid playing. They can't see their kids.
When a student says, hey, coach, can you come? You know, we're playing tonight. Can you? That's one of the reasons that I'm there.
Yes. And they love it. And, you know, I sit down there and just watch them all come in. Y'all, let's watch the band. Yeah, and I need to get down there too. Hey, I enjoyed this, Desmond. Thank you.
So,
the silky smooth voice of John Cardwell coming to you tonight. So I'll turn it back over to Cecil. Hey, have a great day. Go Pirates.
There you go. The card wall has spoken.
Drum majors, Addison Von Trobo, Meredith Bates, and Gustavo Aguilera. Is your band ready? On behalf of Pinnacle Drum Corps, we proudly present the pride of the Eastern Shore, the Fairhope High School Buccaneer fans.
Thomas Hospital special? Our team. Our team makes us so special. We have great physicians, great staff, and great volunteers.
We serve a lot of needs. We impact a lot of people. Baldwin County is the county everybody wants to live in.
People, when they talk about Thomas, they talk about the experience. They talk about how well we interact with the families. And I just think it's a wonderful place to be.
Over the years, I've come back to Thomas Hospital because it feels like a family. Thomas Hospital is a family-friendly environment who cares for you all the way from the time you're born all the way to the end of your life.
My favorite thing about working here at Thomas Hospital is the underlying attitude of the staff, where there is an understanding that we're all kind of looking out after each other.
You can't schedule an illness or injury. That's why AlphaCare Urgent Care is open late every day. The care you need when you need it. Locations in Spanish Fort and Fairhope. AlphaCare Urgent Care, changing the way healthcare is delivered on the coast.
Viger 12 over Williamson's nothing. McGill 31, Robertsdale 0. And Baldwin County High School 14 over Theodore 7. Thanks to AL.com for being here tonight. We're going to give you a few minutes before we give that $400 away to the next ticket. We had to go to the second ticket last week, so it's not unprecedented. 5423250. Cannot watch Pirate Football Live, you can join us at El Mexicano in Fairhope, where they are broadcasting PirateNationLive.com, and you get some great Mexican food at the same time. Tonight, Scott Berry and Cecil Christenberry, your hosts on the air. I'd like to thank Thomas Hospital for the help, Hunter Security, Gulf Orthopedic, Thomas Roofing, all the great sponsors of Pirate Nation Live. We'll give you a couple of minutes and we'll draw our second ticket. Yeah. All right, the Fairhope Pirates will receive the kickoff to start the second half. It's a good time to thank all our volunteers tonight. Friday night football with the Pirates does not just happen coincidentally. There are maybe not hundreds, but many, many dozens.
Scott, I got to tell you something. Great interview with John Cartwright.
Well, thank you. That was fun to talk about our school.
There's a lot to talk about.
Fairhope is huge.
Yes.
School-wise. And yes. There's so much going on. You wouldn't believe this, but there are over 200 students signed up for the pickleball club.
Oh, my gosh. What a
So
race.
We're trying to figure out how to make that happen for them. We got new pickleball courts coming,
Yeah. But
they're not quite ready. But anyway, that's just small potatoes compared to everything that's going on.
But the fact that we got FFA, we got a goat. Do we have a goat yet? Three
goats?
Got
four goats.
Four goats. I knew we had chickens.
Chickens, goats.
Hey, you know, with Ted Hoffman and all back in the old days, you know, I'm just really thankful that
they're bringing that type educational process back.
Yeah, you're a Mississippi State Bulldog. I'm an Auburn Tiger. I mean, we need to get back to our
agreement. I agree. Yep.
Hey, we received the second half kickoff.
Yes, sir.
You had something you want to say?
Well, I was just going to say that the band did an awesome job.
Always do. And the cheerleaders, they all got neon
bandanas
on. Yep. Hey, we got someone watching from San Diego, California, due to a work trip. Thank you for streaming so we can still watch the game. His son, Aaron, number 32, he's a kicker for Mary Montgomery.
Well, he put y'all ahead.
So he did. He did a fine job.
No,
I'm glad
no
we
bad
got to
wishes.
Witness that.
There he is, kicking it off to the Pirates.
That's right. No fair catch. He's coming up the sidelines.
Nice cut.
Come on around.
Uh-oh.
Hold the ball.
Just don't give it back to
Pretty
them.
Pretty good return. It's going to be outside the 35, about the 36 or 37-yard line. Chris Boyington, he said it sure is hot.
Good old Chris. Look, we did a good job of controlling the tempo of the first half. Defensively, we held them to 10 points. I believe their average is probably close to 14 to 18.
That's right. 42, 19,
I feel like defensively we held them in a good situation.
That's right. That's right. We need a light. I don't need a light.
I'm good right now.
I can't see that anyway. Light wouldn't help.
So,
first down, Pirates. Robinson takes the handoff. He's got him open in the middle. Good tackle.
Job.
First
Throw
down.
And catch.
What did you say during the – it was going, what?
Well, we talked about going down the field, setting up plays in the first half to make the defenders anticipate short, and then we throw long. So
that was a mighty – Preston's got it.
Preston could be. Nice job. Throw – he's out of bounds.
He's out of bounds.
He's down.
He's pointing down. He was down.
Yep. So first down, nice throw and catch. Good job by Sanders sealing – that inside defender to not be able to get there. So
that was a good toss out here, too.
Yep.
Right to him, and he could just take it.
Yep.
Head in the right direction.
Coach Joel is a mastermind at creating deception. See, first down at the 38.
There's that shift.
Uh-huh.
When they brought that out at the Spanish Fork game, I thought we had jumped. Good running, hard running. Oops.
Yeah, he's going to break one before too long.
Our Friday evening tradition, L. Max, margaritas, then come home to watch Pirate Nation Live. Great job, guys. Thank you for letting us know, supporting our sponsors.
So the
that's a hard throw right there.
Throw.
Hold the ball.
Ooh. That was lucky. They hit each other harder than they hit Jackson.
We'll take it.
Jackson is, for those of you that have been here a while, it's Coach Jack Robertson from Faulkner State / Coastal's grandson.
Yes.
And there's some athletic ability in that circumstance right there.
His dad is
the coach now at Coastal's.
Family tradition.
Uh-oh, there we go. Downfield
is
wide open.
He's
got the
ball
on
the 10-yard line.
That's a great throw,
great
catch.
That was a great pitch and catch. all the way down to the, is that?
JJ.
Yeah.
He's needed that ball all year.
Perfect.
He's been struggling a little bit with his hand, so that's a great.
He didn't struggle on that one, brother. That was on target.
It'd have been awesome if he hadn't had to die, but we'll take the big play.
First and 10 on the 10, right outside the 10.
There he goes.
Preston right up the middle. He's fighting for yards. Hold on the football. Hey, listen to this. Future Mr. and Mrs. Spencer Cole Closure. Say go Pirates. Well, that's a name out of the
a little bit back. So the cross country team,
congratulations,
with Coach Davidson, Brittany Davidson, who's new to our program. I believe they have a cross country meet tomorrow in Mobile. So get rid of it. Throw it away. Oh, nice.
Nice play. That's right. It's going to be third down.
A little bit early.
You know, one
That's
thing
Tad.
That I
Get up, Tad.
Appreciate about that is he didn't find somebody open. He didn't panic.
Right.
Came over here to us waiting for somebody to open. They didn't.
Well, Tad did a good job of shielding the defender behind him and gave him an option. The defender made a good play. I apologize.
That's right.
I think it was number 5 for them.
Third down, third and 9.
Oh, it's all right. Good job.
Here we go.
I kind of wish we would run a backdoor tight end pop to the other side, roll him this way, and then throw it all the way back to Sanders on the other end. But Coach Joel knows what he's doing.
Yes, so, he does. This will be from the 15, 25, 26-yard field goal attempt.
And that'll be by Campbell McKellar.
He's got the distance. He's got it right down the heart. We're tied.
Tie ball game.
9 minutes. Good job. 27 seconds left in the third quarter.
By Clayton Noblet. And I got to throw those snappers out there.
Yeah, you got to, man. What a job. You know, they snapped the ball. They got somebody right over.
Correct. But they're not allowed to hit them. So it's still a little bit of a
thought process.
Is he going to hit me or not? But
yeah. Well, if he hits you, is it a 15-yard penalty? I mean, if you don't
get a personal foul.
Yeah. Well, since we've tied it up, I'll read this. Skull Vikings, which we understand means Skull Vikings. Shout out to Mary Montgomery Cheerleaders. We see them across there.
Yep. So Coach Davidson wanted to talk about some of the people that are running really well. Anna Bowler Conyers finished 12th in a meet over the last couple of weeks with Lane Watson. Had a personal best of 8:56 and set a school record by 42 seconds.
42 seconds.
Yep. So that's pretty impressive. But good job by Coach Davidson and the cross-country team.
And they have a meet tomorrow.
That's
somewhere
correct.
Somewhere in Mobile, yeah.
They're leaving at 6 o'clock, I believe, to go.
Oh, my goodness.
Somewhere over in Mobile.
Do they take a bus or they?
They will, yes.
Oh, I thought he caught a fair catch.
Don't dive.
That's it. Brought it out to about the 32-yard line. Marley's parents are watching from West Palm Beach saying, go Pirates. I remember in the good old days, they would come up for a ball game and bring us cookies.
Well, they were here this past week. So
I was able to see them and hang out with them a little bit.
So they're,
well, we
they're always
it.
Supporting of their
West
wonderful
Beach.
Daughter, Marley.
Oh, what a job she does.
And then Alex. We don't want to forget Alex. Nice play to open the half, Mr. Kimbrough.
All right, defense.
So we need to. We need a big play here, maybe him throw an interception. I think we keep creeping up towards that camera. And we
do. And, look, if I talk over you, I'm sorry, I'm having trouble hearing you.
That's hard to believe.
It is. I'm having trouble hearing you. Up the middle, twisted around.
Ooh,
that's
nice
a good
hit
run.
There at the end.
Flowers on the carry. Well,
that booth on the staff. Linebacker in the middle.
Dallas
Booth.
Second and four for the Vikings.
Second and four.
Looks like Patrick PJ is on the
First down, drives him out of bound on about the 46-yard line.
You don't see a lot of girth on our teams, but I tell you, they are conditioned, they're strong, and they're intelligent. The coaches do a great job of getting them in shape and their minds ready to understand their part of the defense. If you watch, they are always in – not always, let me rephrase that, but they're pretty much every time in the right spot. They may be out-athleted.
11 hats to the ball.
There's a boom.
Now, look, we got to call that name.
That is, I'm pretty sure that's Nolan.
It's Nolan Phillips. Yes, it is. Nolan met him. Thank you, sir.
That boy didn't know what was coming. That's a big time play. That's a next level defensive play right there that you can't teach.
I recall.
Instinct and speed and just know how. So we're proud of Nolan and his accomplishments. You know, this summer he played in the All-Star baseball game at the state level.
He was hit. Uh-oh.
There he is.
Hey, he broke it up. Oh, no, what a play.
That
just wasn't supposed to happen. Oh, my goodness. He tipped that ball up.
He was right there. Tough luck. Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good.
My goodness gracious, that hurt in the heart right there. I thought we had broken that play up. We got the Fenner family from Sims pulling for their number 7, Jared, the quarterback.
Super
threw
athlete.
That ball down the field, didn't he?
Yeah, we were well defended. Well, with pressure on him. So South Alabama's getting a good one if that's where ends up. Dang, that was a big play. Big play.
I don't think he got it. He's
weak.
That's just
there.
That's just a pair of thinking.
Number 32, since we called.
Wishful thinking. Okay, well, how do we answer? 17-10.
2, 3, 1, 4, 2.
Liza Hayes, I see my Santa Claus. Talking about Liza Hayes, you a sweet thing. She has been so afraid. This is going to be the year.
Yeah.
Oh,
well, good.
So the
boys soccer program has tryouts coming up in October. So anybody that's interested in that, that's listening, grandkids, parents, whatever, tell them they need to go see Coach Stroud before 16th. Got to have some things to make sure that happens. My son plays on the soccer team. It's going to be a special year with some of the seniors that are coming back.
Yes.
So we're real excited about where that's headed. But Coach Stroud has those packets if anybody needs that. So just a quick shout out. Dez is a hardworking, the guy when it comes to Pirate Nation Live.
Absolutely.
His son is in the master's program at the University of Maryland in International Education Policy. So, Dez is a very intelligent man, works really hard, but that parlayed into intelligent children. So
we're
excited for
Reese. You met Dez's wife?
So we got a good, pretty decent kickoff. Let's see.
Get on the ball.
Not good.
Get around him.
Get up the field.
He made chicken salad.
Yes, sir.
He did.
So we're proud of Reese and
absolutely right.
And Dez, we appreciate what you do. I know that you get a pat on the back every once in a while. But
Pirate Nation Live through the Booster Club. Yes. That's the man right there.
So we appreciate this opportunity.
Hey, and these young people out front that are working so hard, we got Michael Brantley, Katie Black, and Landon Dooley. And I've gotten a couple of texts from Will Reed. We've already mentioned that. Will's got a fantastic career head videographer.
Well, you know, Will played football for me as a seventh grader.
He
came to me and he said, "Coach, I just don't know." I said, "Will, I got a place for you." And I said, "I'm going to need somebody to video my games.
Come on.
And help." And that's.
Look what you started.
I will take a little bit of credit.
Well, you should, because he's got a great relationship with Coach Freeze. You know, he was at Ole Miss, he was at Liberty.
Yep.
And now he's in heaven.
Well, I don't know about all that.
He's in paradise. He's right where he's supposed to be.
Yeah.
They got 40, 14 people on the videography crew. Yeah,
that's a big deal. You can make some good money. Uh-oh, get out of there.
Oh, he tried so hard. It's going to bring up third down and long.
Running the football.
Hey, well, I got to say that Navarre, there are many ways to raise your home's curb appeal and replacing your roofing system when replaced. Our personal favorite is copper.
The reason we mention it,
huh?
I like that copper look.
Hey, copper flashing paired with an Atlas design shingle is turning this Jackson, Mississippi home into the envy of a subdivision. Reason we're mentioning that, these fine folks at Navarre, it's Navarre, right? Not Navarre. If I said it wrong, I'm sorry. Navarre, that's right.
Yeah, it's on the
they made a bottled water. Yeah, there it is. There it is. There it is. They made a bottled water donation to the stadium concession stand. It takes a village.
Oh, no doubt. And water is a premium here.
We appreciate all of our sponsors, football sponsors. We appreciate you talking about other teams and opportunities of extracurricular activities.
Looks like it was a penalty on the Pirates, and we went backwards, so it's third and about 14 if my eyes show.
I think your eyes are right. There's 6 minutes and 58 seconds. Clock's running. That is in the third. Got some scores from other Region 1. He brought it down. He was not going to make a mistake. Threw it away. Fourth down.
So Coach Powell sent me a shout-out to the softball team. You know, they finished second in the state last year, just kind of ran out of gas
yes.
there at the end.
Yes.
But they have tryouts coming up this coming week, September 19th, 29th. So those are some of the days they need to participate. They got to have a current physical. But some of the seniors have already committed. Jesslyn Gordon is going to Spring Hill. Zoe Ellis, Enterprise State Community College. Riley Faith Turner is going to Meridian Junior College. So there's some potential coming up through our
fair catch inside the 40.
Right. Good job getting out of that hole that we were in because we went backwards there.
Step
so
up defense.
Still pretty good field position for the Vikings. So just kind of moving forward with some of our teams that are here on campus. The boys track team, you know, we always have very talented runners, distance sprinters, and then the field events have been really good over the last couple of years. Talked to Ben Clapp, who's trying to decide where he wants to go, but he's a decathlete, which means
yes.
five opportunities, long jump, then some sprinting and then a high jump, and I believe a pole vaulting is involved in that, but he's trying to decide. And then some all county situation, of course, Ben, Lane Watson, Ty Watkins, Amir Adams, Walker Rux finished third in the state in the high jump last year. Jason Connolly, Will Garner, and Tucker Petrus are the young men that made all county, and then the girls were Reagan Hadley, Delaney Hart, and Mackenzie Stockton. So we've got a lot of talented athletes that are also great students at Fairhope. So
we got somebody to throw a shot put.
We do not quite as far as Bruiser could throw it.
Oh my word!
But we got That's a couple that can throw it.
Since you called us out on the treats, we had donuts for you, but you forgot to bring them to the game. We enjoyed them on the drive back to Florida.
I hear you. I know what you ate when you were here.
Hey, by calling out, okay.
I know that brisket.
Let's do a commercial. What are we going to do? Is this Thomas? Thomas Hospital. We did earlier said a nice thing or two, but there's a whole bunch of other folks. Don Tippett, Ben Pace, Austin Young, David Thomas, Trevor Newton, John Marlowe, Kenny Eagle, Rodney Kilgore, Bobby Owens, Justin Frazier. Here we go.
Throwing it deep
Throwing
again,
it deep
trying
again.
To get.
He's got number two. They're hand fighting.
Oh,
hey,
come on now.
Hey, I'm gonna call out on the.
They were both doing whatever was going on.
There is such a thing as offensive
That's
pass
correct.
Inefficiency, right?
Coach Carter is not a happy man.
I agree with him.
They're in our apprentice program. But we'd like to thank all of these guys.
So they're going to discuss it.
While we let them talk about it, big shout out to the Pirate Nation Live from Chad Castevens.
Well, good old Chad.
No one does high school sports better. Fairhope will always have a special place in my heart. Coach Berry was one of Dylan's and Madison's favorite coaches. Pirates play my alma mater. Skol Vikes.
I'll pay you later there, big guy.
Hey,
I appreciate that.
Hey, that worked out pretty good, didn't it?
Oh, you got your wish. We got a pass interference on the other side when we're on defense.
Coach Carter was exactly right. He saw that as it was occurring. Just no question.
Coach Carter don't miss much.
That's for sure.
So it was awesome to hear from Riley earlier.
Wasn't that
great? But we have a lot of athletes that go on to play at the next level. We'll talk about some of those guys.
I wonder who they play tomorrow. Who's got Duke tomorrow?
I think Wake Forest, but I'm not 100% on that.
Oh, man.
We talked about it last night at dinner. But
I looked it up, but that was more than 12 hours ago. First in a long way. He's going to throw it deep again. Whoa, good play.
Good
ball
good
was
defense
behind
right
him.
There with him.
Step by step.
Yep, I think
step by step.
Nolan had saw that a little bit quicker. He might have had a chance. But I'll kind of go through this as quick as possible. But Coach Hunter, sorry,
my brain line
went blank. was talking about Sunday Night Lights, the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th of October. They're going to have 6th and 7th grade boys come out to the field and hit under the lights there on the baseball field. So that's a pretty good opportunity.
Absolutely.
If you're interested in that,
right,
check out Instagram at FairhopeBB or the former Twitter.
Twitter X, yeah.
It's X now. Oh, that's a block in the
back. They didn't call that, but that was a good pursuit.
Nice. But you can find that at all the social media pages at FairhopeBB and get that information. So appreciate Coach Hunter telling me about this today. We've had Jackson Hatcher, Ben Mosley, Holland Brock, Matt Young, Brooks Brassfield, Micah Morgan, Keaton Fuller, Bryce Knox, Cam Brock, John Bernard, and Matt Bernard, all playing at the next level from Fairhope baseball.
Hey, see, that's what I'm talking about.
And then, of course, Nolan played in
Stephen said, go Pirates, and go Pirates. This is third down. Good block official. That's going to be fourth down and long. Fourth and long.
Number, got a little bit of jaw in there by number.
It is fourth down for the Vikings.
Fourth down.
Number one. That's Amir. Good old Amir. Love seeing him walk down the hall. Just a presence there in the school.
Fourth and a long way, and they're going for it. The ball's on about the 42-yard line of the Pirates. 4 minutes and 48 seconds with the clock's running in the third quarter. 17-10. Pooch kick. Quick kick.
Get in
bounce
the end
on
zone.
In the end zone, and it did. It did.
Good job. We get.
Well, that was close.
Yeah, that was a pretty good play on their part. Pretty
hey,
smart.
I said,
nobody's back.
I said right, something so, about halftime score. Citronelle's leading Alma Bryant 13-7. Daphne ahead of Davison 35-14. And Foley's beating Baker 28-21.
So we got first down. Score 17-10. We need to drive the ball. Need a big play just to kind of open up things.
Let's
kind of like
it.
We did last series.
We moving around. I'm sorry. This is Go Sims. You know, Sims, I forget what you call that, but it's spelled the same forwards and backwards. What is that, Coach?
Run. Pass interference.
Oh, no. I was afraid he was getting over the line of scrimmage. That's the second tip. Okay, let's straighten that. We got a scrum going on down here in the sidelines. Hate to see that.
Yeah, that was them all day.
Yeah.
They just pushed Jackson all the way to the thing, and then we had somebody come in and protect the quarterback, and then somebody hit him from behind. So it should be multiple on them. But we'll see.
We'll have them sorted out. While they're sorting it out, you know, this is the 50th reunion for the class of 1973. They're going to have dinner tomorrow night. They're here tonight.
Yeah, they had a little gathering right there outside the concession stand. So that was nice.
I got a call and asked to do the invocation, which I was really grateful for. And I'm thinking, class of 73, good Lord, that's older people.
Yeah.
I'm going to practice that a little bit.
Miss Sharon Pippen, who is a stalwart for our talk about videographer and photographers, she is the be-all and end-all here at Fairhope. And she's not able to be with us, but she's chairing on the Pirates and the band.
Great band.
Great show by the band.
You know, I missed seeing her with her camera work all over this place. Hey, Duke is playing Northwestern tomorrow.
Oh.
Go Riley. They're sorting it out. We got both coaches on about the 18-yard line greeting one another. But anyway, that's just a couple years after I graduated, so I'll be right in there amongst them.
There you go.
Yeah, I look forward to it.
Yep.
I got a call to ask if I had any dietary restrictions. What is that?
Dietary restrictions. I guess maybe if you're allergic to food.
So far, no problem.
I definitely am not allergic to any food.
Hey, but I appreciated him thinking of that. I would have never thought of that.
Because I deal with Coach Gilson, who is highly allergic to peanuts.
Oh, yes.
And,
yes.
I actually stopped eating peanut butter because I didn't want to put her at risk. So.
I have a grandson. They found out when he was a little bitty baby at the ballpark that he is totally allergic. And he's 9 years old now.
Yep. It's a tough deal.
I started giving him a peanut just to see if he was over it, but I thought I better not do
better
that.
Better not.
I wouldn't do that, Reed.
All right, so they're still trying to decide what's going on.
That was a tip. That's twice. Interception. One tip, we tipped it into the receiver's hand. Let's remind you, it's 17-10, 4 minutes. Dad told us, back up. I get so excited, I got to look down that way.
that was a tough play. He probably should have went ahead and run with it and got what he could. He's new at this pretty much with being in the big lights in that situation, just trying to make a play. And I thought that it was a little early contact on the defender's part. And hopefully we have a good outcome of the flags. And we don't give up another big play. So.
Are they going to offset them, or are they just going to?
All right, here we go.
Here he comes. Let's see what he says.
After the interception, a personal foul on the return team, personal foul on the offense. The penalties will offset to be first
down. Yeah, that's.
Yep.
It had to be that, I guess, just because. Yeah. But if they'd have seen what we saw from this side, it was unfortunate that it happened at all.
You know, it's a great advantage. We have a great advantage up here in this booth, and we can see things. We can see holes opening up and patterns run.
Yeah, the
on
height.
That field, it's flat.
Yeah. So, looks like they're talking to coach.
Oh, we can, yeah.
Maybe some
unsportsmanship. Let me first, the ball's on the 17-yard line. 4 minutes, 18 seconds left in third, 17-10, Vikings.
Yeah, I think
we both have all of our timeouts left. Not that matters so much.
Well, eventually it may come down to some timeouts later on in the game.
Well, let's save them. Let's save them. Hey, you know one thing about our homecoming parade this coming Thursday? Boy, it's going to be something else. That's the 100th anniversary of Fairhope High School. And I spoke with Ms. Nelson this afternoon. She and Linda Higby Smith and Lynn Tate, they've been working on this. They're going to have floats from the decades. I think they're going to have hippies and soldiers.
There weren't hippies back then, were there?
I'm not sure about that. Hey, but 6 o'clock this coming Thursday starts at the municipal place, goes down section, turns right on Fairhope Avenue and leads you right down the bottom of the hill where there's going to be a big old homecoming bonfire. Yep. They have been working on this for a year. And I got a email address, a website. This is a website. Lowercase FHS100.com. If you need any information or whatever, just let them
know. I know the students are super excited. This will be the first time in a couple of years that we've been able to have the parade. And, you know, we're real excited about that. And the police department, Mayor Sullivan, have been a big help in allowing this to happen. Obviously, you have to shut down some streets and kind of push those people that are normally downtown into a different area so we can.
That's right.
But we appreciate the police department and those type things.
That's tough running up the middle. He's going to get 5 or 6 yards,
fumble, 7, 8 yards. We'll see.
Everybody but the official.
Yeah. They didn't see what everybody else saw.
Second one, number 8.
Bend and don't break. Strip that ball.
He's going to have the first down.
Yep.
First and goal, ball's on the 8-yard line.
We need a play here that goes backwards.
I'd vote for that. I can hear you fine. He caught it.
Nope. It went through his hands.
I could.
A little bit high.
High and hot. The ball well came in high down and the hot. Field.
The second half.
Please stop talking so much. We can't hear the game. What does that mean? too bad for you. In all respect. Second down, second goal on the 5. Stacking.
Nice job.
That is a nice job. He might have gotten a yard.
Fumble this time. What are they going to say? Nope.
Third down. Ball's on the 5, is it? That's inside the 5. It's on about the two. About the 2.
We appreciate the city and the hard work that goes into this facility.
Absolutely.
Yep. Touchdown.
All right.
Two minutes. Tough play on the interception seconds. That leads to a touchdown and puts them up.
It's 23
scores with 2 minutes 33 to go in the third.
Pretty good kicker here if he gets a good snap. Right down the middle, 24-10. Well, that sounds kind of familiar, doesn't it?
Yeah, that really did put us on the back burner there as far as momentum. But it could have, he could have caught it just as easy as he didn't catch it as
That's
far
right.
as our receiver.
This is a crucial time. When we took the second half kickoff and marched down the field, we need to do that again, back into this thing. We can do it. We got the quarterback, we got the running back, and we got the receivers. Mary Montgomery's homecoming is next week. Shout out to our senior cheerleader, Shayla, for being on the homecoming home queen court from Queen Bee Maumau. Go our Skull Vikings. Great game, Pirates. Appreciate you putting that on there.
Shout out to Amir, Preston, and PJ from Anthony Brown, Shay Shay Brown, and the family. Appreciate that.
Hey.
Hope Shay Shay's doing well.
Yes.
Let us know his playing opportunity if you get a chance. So we need a big return here. They haven't kicked it deep, and they typically kick it to the corner so they can put us. They kicked it to the middle. Oh.
That's going to back us up. Just mishandle that ball. Where are we? Inside the five?
Looks that way. That's probably something you don't practice very often. And just miscommunication. You got it. I take it. Kind of deal, and unfortunately it went backwards.
Gotta communicate.
And to be honest, I'm not sure who the returners are tonight with some of the non-participants and some injury situations.
Well, we dug ourselves into a hole. Got a long way to go. One play at a time. Well, they having a conversation there. We mentioned Thomas Roofing. They've been there since 1968. They built a reputation for excellence by adhering to the highest standards of performance at every phase of the roofing process.
It'd be nice for old Preston to jump out there and get a long one.
You know, he's talking about physicals. Alpha Care, right there on Greener Road. They've got one in Spanish Fort, I think, as well. Sports physicals. That's what I was thinking we talked about.
Yes, sir.
Very convenient.
That's
got flu shots, workers' comp, occupational health, school sports physical, respiratory treatments, laceration repair, labs, x-rays.
Looks like personal fouls.
Well, is it offsetting or is it going to get us out of a hole?
Let's see. What does it say? First and 10 on the 3. So maybe it was offsetting. I saw something on the far side pushing and shoving.
Well, just don't do that. 2.5 minutes left in the third. We're down 2 touchdowns. Gonna give us 5 yards.
They jump off sides. We got
ball start.
Oh shoot!
Man, that's
half been doing
the
that
distance,
all night.
That's a yard and a half.
So 2 former Pirates. Making the travel team for South tomorrow, University of South Alabama, Blaine Myrick and Eli Webb are traveling to play Oklahoma State. So that's awesome.
Go Jags!
Yep. We hope both those boys get a little bit of playing time or a lot, whatever that opportunity comes, and they'll
– Sure fun to watch them out here over the years. Hard running up the middle. That's what I'm talking about. Second and five.
So I got this text from Blaine's dad. He's third string at Mike linebacker and playing a little bit on special teams. So we're hoping for a good opportunity for him tomorrow.
I hope he does. He's a freshman, right? Or a sophomore.
He is a Yes, he's a redshirt freshman. He redshirted last year.
That's right. So you were that young coach on the end with all the hair.
Yes, sir.
With Joe D, Coach D.
I believe that year I was 23.
Sanders Daniels, ball was broken up.
Yeah, it's
by their number
tough,
four.
Yeah, tough play there. Once again, trying to make a play.
Sanders has committed to Harvard.
Harvard.
You know, you and Principal Cardwell talked about that, but
yep.
Four young men making perfect, 36 on the ACT. I got their names. I'm going to mention them in a minute.
Yep. Well,
booted out of there. Good punt.
Oh, good punt.
Good punt. Good
punt. Goal ball.
Let him touch it.
There you go.
There you go.
So Sanders made a 35.
That's 35. Yeah. 35.
Which is one away.
Yeah.
That's a good punt by Nolan. That's a big turn of events there as far as field position. So good for him to get in a good
punt. We need one of those tips. You know, that's what's happened to us twice. We need a tip.
Come on, go ahead and tell us who those four gentlemen are.
Peyton Null, they were on TV the other night, did a great job, interviewed right there in the left. Peyton Null, Noah Sugg, Tucker Gooden, Jack McKenzie. Congratulations,
that's
young
awesome.
Man. 36. Boy, that's fantastic. We got 68 members of the 30 Pearls Club. Their big pictures are right there in the hallway. More than just athletics and band. Don't let him out. Got about 8 yards.
Yeah, their offensive line are got the ears pinned back and just pushing forward. So, we like you said, we need a big play here. Somebody needs to pick one off and run it back.
Second down. Come on, defense.
Oh, almost.
Almost swatted it in the backfield or at the line of scrimmage.
Good job, pursuit there, coming up, making a good tackle. The defensive end just missed it. Got 22 seconds, and then we're going to come up with a Thomas Hospital ad here in just a moment. Crowd's still here, pretty excited. The student section, you can see them a little better than I can, but
yep.
They're still hanging
they're
in
still
there.
They're still hanging in, and that's going to bring the third quarter to an end. We're going to the Thomas Hospital High Def sponsor ad.
Had patients tell me that they, you know, were reviewing places to retire to, and they chose Fairhope because of Thomas Hospital and because of the physicians here in the community. So they knew they had excellent health care.
I love Thomas Hospital because of the friendly atmosphere.
It's, they can view it as a trusted friend or a place where they can have confidence and know that they can come and get a fair assessment.
We do see a lot of the patients that we take care of in the emergency room outside of the hospital, and they always come up to us and say thank you, and they're very grateful for the care we provide here.
The patients feel like they are part of our family too, because they don't feel like they're just a number.
Everybody's really committed to serving the community here. You can see that it's evidenced every day by what the staff does to go above and beyond the extra mile for taking care of patients, really meeting their needs.
You can't schedule an illness or injury. That's why AlphaCare Urgent Care is open late every day. The care you need when you need it. Locations in Spanish Fort and Fairhope. AlphaCare Urgent Care, changing the way healthcare is delivered on the coast.
All right, so we need a big fourth quarter here. Obviously down two scores with a little momentum on the Mary Montgomery side. We need a pick here or fumble, or it's looks like it's first down and 10. So
first and 10 snap. On 40 yard line. Yeah, got to keep them out of the end zone. Over's here. We got the ball. Oh. Pick it up.
Gosh.
Oh my goodness. Dog
it. Lay on it.
We're about to do something special right there.
Well, we asked for it. We got it. We didn't, unfortunately, take advantage of it. Gosh.
He was thinking six.
Got big-eyed.
That's right. Hey, in the third quarter, almost in the third quarter, Baker 29, Foley 28,
ooh.
Daphne 56, Davison 14, and Citronelle still leads Alba Bryant. 13-7.
So that's second and about 22, I'm going to say.
Pressure. Get it. That's it.
That's great job of sending the blitz. Number 40, Mr. Harbin.
One of our leading tacklers, yep, and he showed Patrick, why right there.
Patrick came in there like a banshee trying to get to the quarterback. So he is a fun young man to be in class. He just super personable, always making other people laugh. So
how many classes you teach a day?
I have, well, we have eight periods now.
Okay.
And
yep.
So I have a study hall that's fourth, that all everybody has that same study hall. I go to the freshman building to do that, and then I have girls basketball the first period. That's a block in the back.
Don't see the yellow flag.
No. Nope. And then I have six straight classes after that that I teach health.
That's full day.
It and
you drive
a bus.
You still drive a
yes,
bus?
Sir.
Yeah.
That's a tough play. They fake that dive, and he reads that end. If he takes a step down with his athletic ability, he's got six or eight before somebody can even get to him.
Hey, Scott, now I may be a little nervous. We got Rick Cleveland saying, we'd like to say we need a big play. Prep Sports Report guys listening. Well, they do a fine job on Saturday mornings. They cover the coast, the central part of the state, all the way to the north. And I think Rick knows every high school.
If he don't know them, something's wrong
with
them.
That's right. I appreciate he and Mark. They do an outstanding job. And we're
Rick's
glad
been,
a,
Rick's
in,
been around longer than I have.
Yes, sir. Absolutely right.
Good guy, too. We appreciate what he does for high school athletics.
You know, it's spiritual-based, too. I mean, he knows this a whole lot more than just X's and O's
right.
Or whatever, and they don't mind talking about that, and I appreciate him so much.
And all his sponsors, which I – don't really know exactly who that is, but I try to listen on Saturdays, and I've had an opportunity to speak to him on a couple different occasions, so I appreciate that opportunity.
That's good. You get to call in.
Yes,
don't
sir.
You get just a bit nervous when they say, okay, this is the producer, if we're going to let you listen in?
Yeah, it definitely gets you going.
And old Rick said, hey, pal. I love that.
Yep.
Hey, we do need a big play. It's 9 minutes, 39 seconds left in the ball game. 24-10 is 4th and 14 Vikings.
No penalties.
No penalties.
And just try to get possession of the ball.
Absolutely.
And go from there. So it looks like they may, I'm going to guess they're going to pooch kick
pooch
it
kick.
Again.
They did that before. We didn't have anybody back.
Yep. So let's see how far back he
that's
is.
That's still 7. He's standing on the 50-yard line.
Yep, he's going to try to throw it. Long pass. Too far.
No flags, no flags, no flag. That's right.
Good job. Good defense. Didn't right. try to do too much.
Help me with this. With 9.5 minutes left in the ball game, is there hope?
In Fairhope, I would say there always is. If you go back to the first week of the season, we're down 2 scores, and we come back with 4 minutes and 8 seconds, I believe, and score the go-ahead run. So it's very doable. We just got to protect the ball
and get it to
our playmakers.
Nolan had something to do with that, didn't he? Not had a pick six?
No, that was 2 years ago when it was here. I'm talking about there in Spanish Fork the first week of the season.
I got it. You're right. Big play here
looks
now.
Like a
just like Rick was talking about. Big play.
Timeout. Yep, Mary Montgomery. So, 9:28.
They've used 2 of their timeouts, so we have all 3 of ours. 32nd one was 42nd. You know, you mentioned the mayor and the council. Takes a village, doesn't it? They work so well with all of our schools.
Yes,
Farrell,
sir.
Peter Pattern, District 6. We're thankful for this facility and all that they do, the support that they have.
Now, they're in a situation, if you've been on close to our campus on 44 or Twin Beach, and my mind went blank on the softball park field or street there, but they're building a new track.
Is that Colony Drive?
No, it's okay.
I know what you're talking about. Right across from the Dollar General.
Yes, sir. But they're, you know, that facility is going to be ready before track season starts, and hopefully before that.
That's going to be wonderful, too. That's going to be a great facility. Let citizens walk on it, too. Threw it away.
Good idea. Trying to run a little.
Well covered down here. Both low,
go route.
Deep, and yeah. All right, Jackson. We need you, man.
I'm trying to find Tad. I saw him sitting earlier. So. Oh, yes.
What a catch. Running up the field. There he is.
Boy.
First down for sure. Hold the ball. He went up the ladder.
Martin.
We got a replay. There it is. Boom.
Yep, that's
Corey Martin.
Our city council president's son, Corey.
Well, he knew what to do with it when he caught it.
His younger brother has been injured. We're hoping to get him back before too long.
1st and 10.
So that's
Pirates.
One of the big plays we need.
That's one of them.
Get out of a situation.
9 minutes.
They had a little pressure on us, and Jackson didn't rattle. Stood up and threw a good ball.
He was open across that middle right there, wasn't he? He didn't have a chance to get started. Number 36. 36 was like Isaac Campbell. Second 11, 8 minutes left. 8 minutes, 40 seconds.
You got to throw that one quicker.
That's
a late hit.
Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry.
Oh, I got it.
Thank you.
I'd like to see that again. There was no reason for him to hit him like that.
Third down. Third and 11.
Looked like Jackson just couldn't get the ball in his hand, get rid of it there. Good ball.
Way down. Knocked away. He threw it to double coverage.
Yeah,
they
that's
had
a tough
good
ball.
Coverage right there. Yeah.
You just got to hope that he's more athletic than him. Threw it up to his tall receiver. I'd like to see Sanders get a couple of opportunities like that.
Who was that receiver?
That's J.J.
J.J. Jackson.
Jared Jackson.
Jared Jackson.
Junior. Got a lot of upside. We just got to get that potential out of him. So, real excited for him.
Taking a good bounce. Ball. Good bounce. Bounce inside the, right at
inside
the 10-yard line. Okay.
8:17 left in the fourth. We need defense to keep them. I would think they're not going to pass. They're going to probably run some ISO zone reads and let the quarterback do some stuff with his feet. So we need to spy on him and make him make mistakes.
You know, another thing, we're very fortunate here, and I know they're strong in all our schools.
trying to get over here so
but,
I don't get.
But the Booster Club, what a job they do. They pay for Pirate Nation Live.
Yes, sir. They do a wonderful job for our school and the athletes. And if somebody needs something, they just got to ask.
Hey, you've mentioned a lot of teams. Stop him at the line. He's still chilling. You mentioned a lot of teams. The Booster Club, it's not just about football.
No.
It's about
all sports. They do a great job supporting any athletic opportunity at Fairhope.
And
you know, we got a bowling team that's sanctioned by the state.
Yes.
And so they support all of it.
What about fishing? You're fishing team.
We have a fishing team. We had a meeting a couple of weeks ago and trying to get that started, trying to figure out all the hats and T-shirts and all that good stuff.
Quarterback keeper.
Fumble.
You're right. He's staying on the ground.
Yep.
Bring up third and long, third and five.
But, yeah, the fishing team's moving forward. We've got to create our jersey opportunity. So if there's any sponsors out there that love fishing, we'll put you on our jersey.
And that's a fancy shirt, too. Well, y'all do a good job.
It's been pretty good over the years. We've had some really good designs. The students help out with that. So we're pretty excited about their opportunity to use graphics in that situation. There you go.
That's
good
right.
Job.
Fourth down. We're going to get this ball back. 6 minutes, 45 seconds.
We need a bad snap, and we need it to fall in the end zone, and we need to cover it.
That'd be perfect. I'd take that.
He may be a little nervous. He just can't hit the punter in this situation if we try to block it. I didn't have it far enough away from my.
Was it scraping?
Yeah. Kind of like your breathing last week.
Hey, well, that wasn't my I kept hearing breathing. I was thinking it was me. It's good to be breathing, but they ought not hear it out on Pirate Nation Live.
I see the pirate running down with the flag down there.
Yeah.
So there's the student section still excited and being part of what's going on. So.
They'll be excited for homecoming next week. This is the first region game of six. We're in the gauntlet now.
Yep.
I know that there's one off night, open night. When is that?
We've still got time. We've got 6:35. We just got to make a play here without hitting the punter or any of those type things. But we can make it happen.
Is that Tad? I don't think it is.
I think that's
Nolan.
Nolan's
back. Nolan's back. Let's be knocking stuff off. Let's go Pirates.
Bad snap.
Bad snap.
Oh, almost. Don't.
Get away from it.
Almost. Bad. Just we're inches away.
It's game of inches.
So, yep. First down. We got time. We just got to have ball control, throw the ball to the open people.
Man, I go back to those tips. That just wasn't supposed to be. Twice.
Yep. That definitely hurts.
Football. Ball's on the 43-yard line. Going to our left. Let's go.
Oh.
Ball's on the ground. That was Godfrey, but he got hit right in the hands. That hurts. Turnover. 6 minutes, 15 seconds left. They're going to have the ball going the wrong way. Inside our territory. That hurts. I believe that tackler just came in and hit. Right.
Yeah, it was pretty much a collision right there when he handed it to him, so it's unfortunate. Talking about the Foley game. Yeah, I think it's going to be on that Thursday instead of Friday. Yep, so. Yeah, October the 5th instead of the 6th on Thursday. So we'll travel to Foley on the 5th instead of the 6th. And I think Shannon and I have that game.
And that's, we have an open week between Davidson and Foley. That'd be the 22nd.
September the 29th.
Yeah. Why was it changed, do you know?
I am not sure on that.
Come on, defense. They're going to keep it on the ground, as you said, coach.
Yeah, they're going to run the clock out.
6 minutes, 15 seconds. Going to fall forward for a few yards.
I feel like defensively they've played pretty well. We unfortunately give up some big plays offensively that hurt really bad. We give them really good field position. But overall, I feel like defensively we played well. You know, we're two tips away from us scoring versus them.
That's
we
right.
Lied.
No flags.
Air that thing out.
We did have two defenders. He was right between us.
Yeah, he got his hands on it. That quarterback made a nice throw.
5 minutes, 41 seconds.
So our buddies Ben Mosley and Holland Brock are both watching in Andalusia. They're shout out to Preston, Amir, and Nolan, Dixon Davis, from those fellas. Hope y'all are doing well.
Absolutely.
I'm sure fall ball is going well for y'all. So good luck with that. Keep us informed.
Please do, man. We want to hear from you.
Yeah, give me a buzz or a text. Let me know how you hit it that day. I'm sure somebody's hitting some bombs up there.
That's Lurleen Wallace. What is that?
LBW, yeah.
LBW.
I just saw that Foley requested to move the game due to fall break.
Oh.
So thank you for that, Ms. Pippen.
Commercial. Let's do a commercial.
What makes Thomas Hospital special? Our team.
Our team makes us so special. We have great physicians, great staff, and great volunteers.
We serve a lot of needs. We impact a lot of people. Baldwin County is the county everybody wants to live in.
People, when they talk about Thomas, they talk about the experience. They talk about how well we interact with the families. And I just think it's a wonderful place to be.
Over the years, I've come back to Thomas Hospital because it feels like a family. Thomas Hospital is a family-friendly environment who cares for you all the way from the time you're born all the way to the end of your life.
My favorite thing about working here at Thomas Hospital.
Third and seven. 5 minutes, 39 seconds. They're going to air it out again.
Oh,
nice
move. That was a nice little put his foot in the ground and just go by him.
You said he's committed to South, right?
I am pretty sure that's what I was told.
Well, they'll be glad to have him. He's doing an outstanding job. He was like a Houdini on that one. We had him in the backfield. First down, that ball's going to be on about inside the 20.
5:14 and counting. Strip the ball. They're just going
to grind it out.
Yep.
Under 5 minutes to play.
There's a young man walking, and I know y'all can't see him based on the camera angle, but there's a group that all played for me, and they run a gym here locally, and they make a huge difference in our student body and other schools around the area as well. But the Willison brothers, just great guys, spiritual led, just doing good things. Hold on to him.
That's tough running right there. He got 3 or 4 yards after he was stood up.
Big play here.
Clock's running.
356. They're going to drain every second possible.
You know, I know we don't show it, but Montgomery's got quite a few fans.
They brought a good crowd.
They travel well.
This program's on the uptick for sure.
It's good stuff. Yeah.
Nice job. Fourth down.
What are they going to do here?
Call timeout. We got a timeout.
Up two.
Mm-hmm. Going to commercial.
You can't schedule an illness or injury. That's why AlphaCare Urgent Care is open late every day. The care you need when you need it. Locations in Spanish Fort and Fairhope. AlphaCare Urgent Care, changing the way healthcare is delivered on the coast.
I've had patients tell me that they, you know, were reviewing places to retire to, and they chose Fairhope because of Thomas Hospital and because of the physicians here in the community. So they knew they had excellent health care.
I love Thomas Hospital because of the friendly atmosphere.
They can view it as a trusted friend or a place where they can have confidence and know that they can come and get a fair assessment.
We do see a lot of the patients that we take care of in the emergency room outside of the hospital, and they always come up to us and say thank you, and they're very grateful for the care we provide here.
The patients feel like they are part of our family too, because they don't feel like they're just a number.
Everybody's really committed to serving the community here. You can see that it's evidenced every day by what the staff does to go above and beyond the extra mile for taking care of patients, really meeting their needs.
That's false start on the Vikings.
So Matt Young, who I've watched grow up from probably third or fourth grade, is at Lawson State, and he said to say hello and go Pirates. Appreciate you reaching out. Good luck in the fall ball that y'all are probably playing, and hope you're enjoying the college opportunity.
Best years of your life.
So we got 324. It's fourth and eight.
Bowling's ahead of Baker now, 41-36 late in the game. Landon. 3 minutes and 24 seconds here. Fourth down. And Eagle sack. Get him. He's tough to bring down.
Yeah.
He's tough.
Let's look at that replay. He made a good play to get out of that.
He really did. But he didn't break it.
And yeah. Not giving up.
That's right. Let him have. All right. Daphne, final now is 56-14 over the Davidson Warriors.
That was at Davidson in their new stadium?
Yep, in their new stadium. Citronelle and Alma Bryant are tied in the fourth quarter, 13 all. Here we're down two scores, 24-10, 3 minutes, 12 seconds. First down, Pirates.
Oh.
Well.
He didn't set his feet too good on that when he threw it on the run. That's tough on the defense.
That's tough. That's tough.
Go sit down for.
That leaves 3:04. Pete Vikings ball on the 48-yard line. That's tough. Threw that ball a long way.
Yep.
Defender
he'll get better.
Step right inside.
He's a talent. Experience is hurting tonight against a really good team that has some athletes.
And as we alluded to earlier, this Mary G team went to Foley last week, won 28-7. Tough running, about 6 yards.
About 3 minutes.
Second down.
Tough night for the Pirates with the turnovers, inexperienced at quarterback, and he's going to get better.
Yes.
We didn't get an opportunity to get it to our playmakers as much as we'd like. I think Sanders has been targeted maybe twice. And
coming up on 2 minutes left in the ball game. You're right, they're just running clock.
We appreciate the sponsors that we have this year and what a difference they make in our community. Defense is not giving up, which is their character. You know, they do a good job of pride and maintaining that opportunity. Alex said earlier they've been playing hard.
They have. There's no quit in them. I mean, they look at the clock, see a minute and a half left in the ball game. That's tough. That's just real tough.
Yeah, on the screen you see our sponsors. We appreciate them and what they mean to us here at Pirate Nation Live. And we appreciate the Booster Club.
Mm-hmm.
That big defensive lineman we have took up three of theirs that time.
Under a minute. Well, Scott, I appreciate being with you,
yeah,
man.
I've enjoyed
I appreciate
it.
What you do.
Yeah, I love being around high school athletics. Obviously, after 30-something years, we'll just throw 30-something out there. But I love Fairhope and the Pirates, and I hope to, when I do decide to retire, to get a tattoo or something that says,
"Hey, that's a good
Pirates
idea."
On it.
Where will it be on your arm?
Put it right. No.
Anyway,
probably
that
hide
was
it
tough
from my mama, though.
That's right.
Mama wouldn't like it too much.
I'm sure of that. Well, that was a tough one. It looks like the final score is going to be 24-10. Congratulations to the Vikings. They go to 4-0.
Yep.
We're 1-3. Homecoming next week. Homecoming.
A big week for us with that opportunity and the parade. Come out and support that. The bonfire will be at the down by the pier. A lot of hard work. My son and the junior class has been working real hard on their float, and just the opportunity to do that. And, of course, all the classes are doing that as well. So it should be a fun time.
It will be. Absolutely. And appreciate those that are working on the decades float.
Yep, that'll be exciting.
You'll
see a hippie running around in Fairhope. Imagine that.
Yeah, how about it? That's good. Well, anyway.
Congratulations to the Vikings. They're a really good team, and we hope to see them in the playoffs.
Yes.
Down the road. So, their quarterback's really special, and look forward to seeing him at the next level as well.
That's right. Well, there's one thing left to say.
Go Pirates!